Hey guys, Netherite Sword here. In this video, I'm going to show you how to build a system that disables your farms whenever the chests fill up or overflow. Remember to subscribe and like if you haven't already, and let's get started. Start by placing a sensor conveyor in front of the chest you want to track the overflow of. Then take out your steam generator and your timer chest. And a coal totem. This will be our main power supply for this build. Place a conveyor in front of a coal totem. With a timer chest in front of that. Set the timer of the chest to 35 seconds. In front of that, place a steam generator. Place a splitter in front of the steam generator. This will split the power from the steam generator into two parts. Now use your wiring tool to connect the steam generator to the splitter. Connect the left input of the splitter, no, the left output of the splitter, to the input of the sensor conveyor. Then place an AND gate. In front of the splitter. And connect the output of the sensor conveyor to the right input of the AND gate. It doesn't matter which input you connected to, I'm just using it this way to make it simple. My mistake, actually connect the right side of the splitter to the right side of the AND gate. Now we're going to place an OR gate facing the AND gate. Use your wiring tool to connect the output of the sensor conveyor to one of the inputs of the OR gate. Now place a splitter in front of the AND gate and connect the left side pass through of the splitter back to the OR gate. Now place an LED light, and now we're going to connect the right side pass-through of the splitter to the input of the LED light. Connect the output of the AND gate to the input of the splitter. By doing this, we have created a loop so that once the splitter detects an object, it'll supply power to the LED light. But once the object passes the sensor conveyor, the power will still be supplied to the LED light. Oh yeah, and also remember to connect the output of the OR gate to the left side of the AND gate. Now how this works is if we drop one block of marble onto the sensor conveyor, the LED light turns on. But even though the sensor conveyor has stopped sensing the marble block, the LED light is still on. Now with this, we can connect it to a totem disabling system to disable the farm. Now in a different location, we're going to build a second loop. Place a coal totem with a conveyor belt leading away from it. Then place a timed input-output chest in front of the conveyor belt. As always, set the timer of the chest to 35 seconds. Now place a steam generator in front of the timer chest. You will now need a switch in front of the steam generator. Use the wire tool to connect the output of the steam generator to the input of the switch. Then place an OR gate in front of the switch and connect the output of the switch to one of the inputs of the OR gate. Connect the output of the LED light all the way to the second input of this OR gate we just built here. And now connect the output of the OR gate to your totem disabling system. If you don't know how to build a totem disabling system, watch my previous video on that. But we're gonna connect this wire to the input of one totem disabler, and then we're just gonna place totem disablers the whole way down, chained together so that power is provided to all of them. So how this system works is basically this steam generator provides power to the splitter. Now the splitter provides half its power to the sensor conveyor over here. Once the sensor conveyor senses an item, it gives its power to an OR gate. And the other side of the splitter provides power to the AND gate. Once the OR gate receives power, it gives power to the AND gate. Remember, OR gates only require one side to have power, to output some power. When the AND gate's two inputs are on, it provides power to the splitter. The splitter makes half the power go into the LED light, and half the power go back into the OR gate, which again powers the AND gate. This is how we make the electricity loop so that even when the sensor conveyor turns off, the LED light will stay on. And now this LED light will be connected to this thing over here, which will actually enable the totem disabling system once the LED light is on. If you liked this video, please remember to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. And I'll see you guys soon. Bye!